Hello everyone, I hope you are doing well. We are in the middle of the winter in Canada and also in the middle of yet another public health situation. So I hope you are taking care of yourselves and your loved ones. Practicing internal martial arts and Xiu Dao will not only make our body stronger, but will also strengthen our mind and spirit so that we will be able to overcome challenges together. We should continue supporting each other and always be hopeful for a better tomorrow. Last week, I asked the community to introduce some potential authors for the Dao Yi online magazine. Thanks to the community, we received some very good feedback. On behalf of the Dao Yi team, I'd like to express our appreciation to those Discord members. We will take your suggestion into serious consideration and work on it accordingly in the future. Today, we have another idea worth exploring with you, especially those among you that run their own martial arts school. Dao Yi is exploring the idea of having martial arts schools affiliated with Dao Yi. Please let us know your thoughts and expectations out of such affiliation with Dao Yi, either in the comments or on the feedback channel on Dao Yi's Discord, or email us at feedback@daoyi.org. Before we dive into today's topic, let me make a couple of language-specific announcements. First announcement for our Russian-speaking practitioners, Mr. Denis Ryshetnikov, a practitioner and a teacher based in Russia, has recently started working on providing Russian language captions and voiceovers for my videos. Link is in the description. I recommend you check out this channel and also let other Russian speakers know if they are interested in those topics. Second announcement for our Spanish-speaking practitioners, at the request of the YouTube channel Diving History Mar de Plata Argentina, I'm also enabling Spanish language captions on the video, but since the captions are auto-translated, I cannot guarantee the accuracy of the captions. So if any Spanish speakers in the community are willing to spend time on providing captions and voice covers like Mr. Denis Ryshetnikov is doing for Russian speakers, please let me know and I will gladly announce it on my channel. And that's about in terms of this week's announcements. Let's look at today's main topic. Today, I'd like to talk about Youshen, or swimming body, an advanced concept and practice of internal style martial arts. I believe you may have noticed or heard of this term before, especially in Bagua practice, such as Cheng style Bagua. Regardless, in addition to introducing Youshen, today I'd like to extend the scope of Youshen knowledge from Bagua to another styles such as Xingyi, since it is a quite advanced practice in internal style martial arts. I'm sure you will find today's video useful, no matter what stage you are at in your practice. Topics covered in today's video include, first, meanings of Youshen. Second, history of Youshen. Third, Xingyi and Youshen. Fourth, practice of Youshen. Fifth, principles of Youshen. Sixth, misconceptions of Youshen. Seventh, demonstration of Youshen. And eighth, takeaways. Unfortunately, Quebec has reimposed restrictions, including a curfew, which caused scheduling conflicts for us. So today's video will not have the student correction section. Hopefully, we should be able to resume it soon. So, without any further ado, let's get started. Topic 1. Meaning of 游身. The term 游身 consists of two characters. 游 means swimming and 身 means body. Put together, the literal translation is swimming body. To the best of my knowledge, there exists no prior definition of 游身, I'm the first to define it. I define 游身 as the dynamic approach to 身法 or the body method, which includes but isn't limited to 灵活 flexibility, 连贯 continuity, and 适应 adaptability in a natural expression of martial practice. 游身 is most commonly used in 八卦 practice. Let me play an old video clip of myself that I posted about 2 years ago so you can get a visual idea of 游身. This is the typical Cheng style swimming body exercise that I created in order to teach my students. But in today's video, I will focus on the application of 游身 in 形意 practice, which is an advanced practice. Now, many of you, especially 形意 practitioners, may wonder why 游身 has been an unheard of concept in 形意 practice so far, or if it even exists in the first place. Well, like I have mentioned quite a few times in the past, advanced topics are usually not that popular and as a result often become extinct if not misinterpreted over generations. And as I mentioned in my 99th video, as a 传人 of the internal styles, it is my duty to impart conceptual knowledge of these styles, even more so when it comes to advanced, uncommon, and hard to understand concepts. Well, the best things in life are free. Please keep in mind that 游身 practice may look very simple and easy. In reality, it is not easy to master at all. 游身 is a way to express your understanding of the practice and not merely to copy one's movement. In martial art practice, mastery of a 身法 or body method is always more challenging than arm or leg movements. To achieve it, you need specific training and diligent practice. More importantly, it becomes even more challenging to apply 游身 to a style like 形意, which is very well known for its visually linear movement. Advanced practice in the internal styles will never be linear, which is a very well known reality in China. But the million-dollar question is, how to make linear movements circular in 形意, or in other words, how to apply 游身 to 形意 practice. After watching this video, you may not be able to master 游身 right away, but at least you will be able to appreciate 游身 practice and have a good idea on how to practice 游身 yourself. So, what is the history of 游身? That brings us to the next topic. Topic 2. History of 游身. 游身 or swimming body is a comparatively much newer term in the Chinese martial art community. Nowadays, you may very often encounter the term 游身 八卦掌 or swimming body 八卦掌, which has become synonymous with 八卦. it may give you the impression that Youshen or swimming body was a part of the original name of the style. My research so far indicates that the term Youshen entered Bagua parlance starting with the third generation of Bagua practitioners. If we consider Dong Haichuan was the first generation of Bagua. Dong Haichuan's training poems, which contains his teachings, but were in fact authored by his students, do not contain even a single mention of Youshen. By the way, the first character in the term Youshen is Yu, or swimming, which is the term used to describe the movements of a dragon, a divine animal in Chinese culture. So, Youshen or swimming body actually means the imitation of a dragon movements in Bagua practice. Is the word Yu or swimming the only word used to describe Bagua? Well, not in the least. Actually, there is another sound, Rou, that sounds very close to the character Yu. In Mandarin, Yu and Rou are very similar. Especially in Tianjin, most people pronounce the sound Yu instead of Rou. So, what does the Rou stand for? In the martial art community, the sound Rou can be used to pronounce two words. The first one is the adjective Rou, which means soft. The second one is the verb Rou, which means to knead or to soften through movements. For example, in Tianjin, Gao Yisheng, a student of Cheng Tinghua and the founder of the Cheng style Gao branch of Bagua, used the verb form of Rou to name his practice. While some books use the character Rou, which means soft, in their titles. Also, Cheng Youlong, the oldest son of Cheng Tinghua, who taught and lived in Tianjin, used the word Yu or swimming to describe his Cheng style Bagua branch. Like I mentioned moments ago, the sounds Rou and Yu are very similar in Mandarin. As a result, most later publications adopted the word Yu, which means swimming, to name their book titles and form names. Furthermore, the word Yu or swimming is a much more appealing visualization of the practice since it implies the characteristics of a Bagua practice as a dragon movement. That is why swimming body became a commonly accepted and used term in Bagua. To summarize, the word Yu or swimming has a similar sound Rou, which can mean soft in an adjective form or to knead or to soften through movement in a verb form. Both Yu and Rou are pronounced the same in Tianjin. Topic 3. Xing Yi and Roushen. Now let me introduce the Roushen concept in the context of Xing Yi practice. Like I mentioned earlier in this video, martial art practitioners usually associate Roushen with Bagua practice. It is very rare to hear people talk about Youshen in Xing Yi since it is an advanced topic and in the past, qualified teachers only talked about it with some of their indoor students in Tianjin. Xue Dian, one of the best Xing Yi masters in history, emphasized the Long Xing Youshen or Dragon Style Swimming Body Method, especially in his Xiang Xing Shu system. Some people in Tianjin call Xue Dian's Xing Yi as Dragon Style because of the Youshen approach. I recommend you check out my prior video talking specifically about Xue Dian, his 形意 and 象形术. Link is in the description. As the third generation practitioner and lineage holder of Xue Dian 形意, I was the first person to both demonstrate Xue Dian's practice as well as publish several articles in the public domain in China to introduce the concept of You Shen in Xue Dian's practice. My work in China has been impactful to the extent that many people in the Xing Yi community have gradually but widely accepted the concept of You Shen in the context of Xing Yi practice in China. I believe the concept of You Shen in Xing Yi practice is an evolution of Xing Yi, since it makes it easier and quicker for practitioners to reach higher levels through a set of specific practice. You Shen in Xing Yi, neither the concept nor the practice were explicitly defined before. Refining the existing movements to reflect the You Shen approach is my original contribution to Xing Yi. I'm in the process of further theoretically refinement of the concept, and I plan to publish it in the near future. Now let me show you an older video of mine demonstrating You Shen practice in Xue Dian style Xing Yi. This was originally posted more than 2 years ago. That should give you a quick idea of what You Shen practice looks like in Xing Yi. Now, how should you actually practice You Shen? That brings us to the next topic. Topic 4, practice of You Shen. You Shen is a part of Ba Gua practice, especially in Cheng style. You Shen is emphasized throughout the entire system. Unfortunately, there aren't many documents explaining this concept. As a result, although You Shen may be commonly associated with Ba Gua practice, many Ba Gua practitioners unfortunately lack the You Shen approach in their practice. It's not the style that is to blame, but the practitioners. Rather, a lack of conceptual understanding of You Shen and also the paucity of qualified teachers that understand You Shen. So, it is worth talking about it in today's video. Before going any further, let's review my definition of You Shen that I introduced in the first topic. I define You Shen as a dynamic approach in the body method of Shen Fa, which include but isn't limited to flexibility, continuity, and adaptability in a natural expression of a martial practice. So, the three key aspects here are flexibility, continuity, and adaptability. I will explain You Shen practice based on these three key aspects. First, flexibility. Flexibility is the prerequisite for You Shen practice. In the older times, and even today to some extent, flexibility was called Kai Jian Kai Kua, or opening the shoulders and opening the hips. Without a good level of flexibility as a physical prerequisite, You Shen is simply impossible. I recommend you watch my prior video titled Internal Style Concepts 13, Kai Jian Kai Lei, opening hips, shoulders, and ribcages, to get a better idea about flexibility in the context of the internal styles. Link is in the description. Again, flexibility is achieved not only through stretching, but more importantly and effectively, it is gained through the practice of extending movements in martial art training. If you focus on further extension of your movements as opposite to the common thin short movements, with time you will be able to achieve natural flexibility, which is a prerequisite of Youshen. Second, continuity. Continuity is a result of mastery of the movements at a subconscious level, which means you should be able to perform movements naturally without consciously thinking about them or recalling them in practice. If you have a hard time memorizing a series of movements, then you still have quite a way to go before you can achieve continuity. Also, continuity in Youshen practice is based on circular and spiral movements, which is another key factor in mastering Youshen. I will explain it further in the next topic. So, practicing the movement at a subconscious level and being able to express the movements in a circular and a spiral format is the right approach. Third, adaptability. I define the term adaptability as the ability to self-adapt to the style, which includes both adapting the body to the movement as well as adapting the movement to the body. Sure, it sounds a bit abstract, but let's contemplate on it. In the context of adaptability, an advanced level of martial practice actually entails 自适应, or self-adaptability, in addition to adapting to the external environment. So, in practice, in order to progress to more advanced levels, you have to focus on self-adaptability, which is adaptability between the body movements and the body itself. I conceptualized self-adaptability based on my decades worth of practice and teaching, and I believe it can help you master adaptability better. So, Youshen is the process and the practice of self-adaptability. Of course, you have to practice Youshen physically in order to fully understand it. Also, if you read my definition of Youshen, you can identify other necessary factors for its practice, including dynamic approach, natural expression, and so on. In the interest of time, let's move on to the next topic, which is the introduction of some important principles of Youshen practice. Again, it is already a bit abstract before introducing some more abstract principles, but please keep watching. I guarantee you that with time, you will understand it better and better. Topic 5. Principle of Youshen. As I have mentioned in prior videos, teaching a concept without introducing some key principles will render the learning process incomplete. Understanding key principles can really elevate your overall understanding to a whole new level. I'd like to introduce two basic principles that I use to describe Youshen practice in today's video. They are, first, 一动俱动, and second, 圆活无端. First, 一动俱动. 一 means one part of the body, 动 means moves, 俱 means all the body parts, 动 means moves. Put together, 一动俱动 means one body part moves, all the other body parts move as well. 一动俱动 emphasizes the concept of integrated coordination. By nature, Youshen is a part of Shenfa or body method. The key word in both Shenfa and Youshen is the word Shen or body. Even though the practice is expressed partially by arms and legs, the core practice is the body itself. So it is important to cultivate a natural coordination between the limbs and the rest of the body. Even though it is very hard to say that the body is always the dominant factor in Yoshen practice, since body has to often coordinate with the limbs. The body should still be the part which controls the movements as a whole. So each part of the body should work in unison in order to have an advanced practice of Yoshen. In other words, each part of the body should adapt to each other. That is the reason I emphasized the term adaptability in the context of Yoshen practice. However, 移动聚动 is easier said than done. Sometimes, different body parts will move in the same direction and some other times in opposite directions, all of which need to be practiced specifically. Even more important, many minor yet crucial movements are not very visible, which makes the practice more challenging. Second, yuan huo wu duan. Yuan means circle, huo means flexible, wu means without, duan means end or blockage. Put it together, yuan huo wu duan means that Yoshen is a practice that consists of many circular flexible movements without any blockage. Bear in mind that using circular and spiral movements are critical to the practice of Yoshen. Of course, there are some linear movements involved in Yoshen at a certain point, but overall movements used in Yoshen are circular and spiral. It is even more so in Fali movements during Yoshen practice. I have talked about circular movements in a prior video titled Decoding Martial Proverb No. 7, Curved Movements, Straight Force, and Xing Yi Four Images. Link is in the description. Also, Yuan Huo Wu Duan emphasizes the importance of continuity, which I introduced in the prior section. Bear in mind that in Yoshen practice, there should not be any blockage when you execute a series of movements. While a movement may seem to contain a pause, the apparent pause is actually just a very slow movement itself and not a real pause. In other words, Yuan Huo Wu Duan lies in variation of speed but not in changing the nature of movements from dynamic to static. This is very important since being able to vary the speed according to the movements and the intention of a practice is an indicator of a good practice. To summarize, Yoshen practice should emphasize these two principles. First, 移动聚动, and second, Yuan Huo Wu Duan. If you follow these two principles, your Yoshen practice will definitely improve. I will introduce more Yoshen practice in the future. Topic 6. Misconceptions about Yoshen. There are some very common misconceptions about Yoshen. Today, I'd like to point out two of them. First, Yoshen is based on circular or circle walking. Since the term Yoshen is commonly used in Bagua practice, and the Bagua practice emphasizes a circle or circular walking pattern, people naturally believe that Yoshen is just based on Bagua walking. Actually, the term Yoshen or swimming body is an aspect of Shenfa or body method and talks about Shen. A stepping or walking pattern cannot by itself provide or substitute Shenfa. Second, Yoshen is a soft movement without any fali. This is another very common misconception. Fali is an unavoidable part of internal style practice. Yoshen practice trains the body to move in a specific way. One of the objectives of Yoshen is to practice fali as well. A good practitioner can execute fali when walking on Yoshen. If you ignore fali, you will never reap the full benefit of Yoshen. Topic 7, demonstration of Yoshen. Today, I'd like to demonstrate an exercise for Yoshen practice. Okay, first, slow motion practice. Okay, now, fast motion practice. So, start from here. Topic 8, takeaways. First, what is Yoshen? I define Yoshen as the dynamic approach to Shenfa or body method, which include but isn't limited to 灵活 flexibility, 连贯 continuity, and 适应 adaptability in a natural expression of martial practice. Second, history of Yoshen. My research so far indicates that the term Yoshen entered Bagua parlance starting with the third generation of Bagua practitioners if we consider Dong Haichuan as the fourth generation of Bagua. Third, Xingyi and Yoshen. Even though Yoshen has not been widely discussed in public in the context of Xingyi practice, as an advanced level of Xingyi, it is a must-have. Fourth, how to practice Yoshen. Focus on flexibility, continuity, and adaptability is the key aspect of it. Fifth, principles of Yoshen. First, Yidong Judong, which means when one body part moves, all the other body parts move as well. And second, Yuan Huo Wu Duan, which means Yoshen is a practice that consists of many circular flexible movements without any blockage. Six, misconceptions. First, Yoshen is based on circular or circle walking. Second, Yoshen is a soft movement without any fali. Please do not forget to watch the demonstration section to have a better idea of Yoshen practice. That brings us to the end of today's video. Thank you for watching. See you next time and enjoy your practice.